Welcome to Wings of Fire Dreams. Today we are going to see the family tree of Delhi Sultanate. The first dynasty is Slave Dynasty, also known as Mamluk Dynasty. In 1206, Muhammad Ghor, the Sultan of Ghurid Empire, was assassinated. Since he had no children, his empire split into minor sultanates led by his former Mamluk generals. Qutbuddin Aibak became the Sultan of Delhi, and that was the beginning of the Slave Dynasty. Aram Shah is the son of Qutbuddin Aibak, and Qutb Begum is the daughter of him. However, his reign as the Sultan of Delhi was short-lived, as he died due to injuries received from an accident while playing a game of polo. His horse fell and he was impaled on the pommel of his horse saddle. He was buried near Anakali Bazaar in Lahore. Aram Shah was the second Sultan of Mamluk Dynasty. He briefly held the throne after the unexpected death of Qutbuddin Aibak. An allied group of 40 nobles named Chihalgani conspired against Aram Shah and invited Samsuddin Iltutmish, husband of Qutb Begum, to replace Aram Shah. Aram Shah was defeated and dethroned by Iltutmish. Samsuddin Iltutmish was the strong ruler fighting against Mongols and Genghis Khan and extending his territories. He built Sultan Gari, which was the first Islamic mausoleum in Delhi. Naziruddin Muhammad was the first eldest son of Sultan Samsuddin Iltutmish, born to his first wife Qutb Begum. He was the governor of Oudh and later served as the governor of Bengal until his death. After ruling Bengal for 1.5 years, Naziruddin died in 1229. Rukuneddin was the son of Iltutmish and his wife Shah Turkan, who was the handmaid of Turkic origin. In 1233, he appointed Rukuneddin as the administrator of Lahore. During his last days, when he had become seriously ill, Iltutmish recalled Rukuneddin from Lahore to Delhi, and Rukuneddin was unanimously accepted as Iltutmish's successor by the nobles in 1236. Rukuneddin was not an able ruler and left the control of administration to his mother Shah Turkan. Rukuneddin and Shah Turkan planned for blinding and execution of Iltutmish's youngest and favorite son Qutbuddin, which led to rebellions by several nobles. The rebellions instigated Razia to be their sultan. Razia Sultan is the daughter of Iltutmish and Qutb Begum. Rukuneddin marched towards Khurram to fight the rebels. Shah Turkan planned to execute Razia in Delhi, but Razia instigated the general public against Shah Turkan. A mob then attacked the royal palace and detained Shah Turkan. Several nobles and the army pledged allegiance to the Razia and placed her on the throne, making her the first female Muslim ruler in South Asia. Rukuneddin marched back to Delhi, but Razia sent a force to arrest him. He was imprisoned and probably executed on 19 November 1236. Razia had recalled Ikhtiyaruddin Atigan, a Turkic slave purchased by Iltutmish, to her court in Delhi and made him prime minister. She had also bestowed favors upon another slave of Iltutmish, Ikhtiyaruddin Altunia, assigning him as the governor. But these two officers conspired with the other Turkic officers to overthrow Razia while she was away on the Lahore campaign. Razia arrived in Delhi and came to know that Altunia had rebelled against her in Tabarinda. Unaware that other nobles in Delhi had joined Altunia in conspiring against her, Razia marched towards Tabarinda 10 days later. The rebel forces imprisoned her. When the news of Razia's arrest reached Delhi, the rebel nobles there appointed Mujahideen Bahram, a son of Iltutmish, on the throne. He formally ascended the throne on 21st April 1240 and the nobles pledged allegiance to him on 5th May 1240. The nobles expected the new king to be a huge figurehead and intended to control the affairs of the state, which was assigned to Ikhtiyaruddin Atigan. However, the new king had Ikhtiyaruddin Atigan assassinated within 1 to 2 months. After deposing Razia, the nobles at Delhi had distributed important offices and iktas among themselves, ignoring claims of Ikhtiyaruddin Altuniya, who had arrested Razia. After Etigan's death, Altuniya lost all hope of realizing any benefits from Razia's overthrow and decided to ally with her. Razia also saw this as an opportunity to win back the throne and married Altuniya in September 1240. The two were supported by some other disgruntled Turkic nobles. Altuniya assembled an army, whereas Muzaddin Barham led an army against the forces of Altuniya and Razia and defeated them on 14th October 1240. Altuniya and Razia were forced to retreat to Kaithal, where they were deserted by their soldiers and were killed by a group of Hindus. Razia was killed on 15th October 1240. She remains the only Muslim woman to have sat upon the throne of Delhi. The grave of Razia is located near Turkman Gate in Old Delhi. Razia's grave is said to have been built by her successor and half-brother Bahram. Another grave, said to be of her sister Shazia Behem, is located beside Razia's grave. During his reign, the nobles became disorderly and constantly bickered among each other. Muzaddin Bahram was too weak to take any action against them, and the nobles besieged him in the White Fort of Delhi and put him to death in 1242. The seventh Sultan was Alauddin Masud. He was effectively a puppet for the nobles and did not actually have much power or influence in the government. Instead, he became infamous for his fondness of entertainment and wine. By 1246, the chiefs had become upset with Alauddin Masud's increasing hunger for power and replaced him with his cousin, Sultan Nasiruddin Muhammad Shah, who was another grandson of Iltutmish. The eighth Sultan was Sultan Nasiruddin Muhammad Shah. As a ruler, Muhammad was known to be very religious, spending most of his time in prayer, and was renowned for aiding the poor and distressed. It was his deputy Sultan, Ghiyas-uddin Balban, who primarily dealt with state affairs. Ghiyas-uddin Balban was the Iqbari Turk. He was purchased as a slave by Iltutmish. Balban belonged to the famous group of 40 Turkic slaves of Iltutmish. Balban became the ninth Sultan of Delhi. Balban ruled with an iron fist and broke up the group of 40 noblemen. He tried to establish peace and order in India and built many outposts with garrisons of soldiers in areas where there had been disorder. Balban wanted to make sure everyone was loyal to the crown, so he established an efficient espionage system. Balban's heir was his older son Prince Muhammad Khan, but he perished in the battle against the Mongols. His other son Bughra Khan was reluctant to assume the throne and sought to remain the ruler of Bengal instead. Balban therefore chose his grandson Kaikhosrow, son of Prince Muhammad, as heir apparent. However, after his death, his nobles nominated Qaqabad as Sultan. Qaqabad is son of Bughra Khan. Qaqabad was very weak and incompetent and eventually fell to stroke and had to pass the rule to his 3-year-old son, Samsuddin Kaimers, who was eventually dethroned by his guardian, Jalaluddin Feroz Khalji, in 1290, bringing an end to the slave dynasty. For knowing the family tree of Khilji dynasty, please subscribe to our channel. Thank you.